Today I'm traveling further south, and at the moment I'm traveling through rubber tree plantation. So interesting, I've never seen these trees before.
Somewhere.
more bicycles than cars on this road. I'm traveling now to Port Montclair, and that will be my pretty much last stop at the lake. I'm planning to stay there for a few days and just chill and enjoy my last days in Malawi. So now I'm traveling, I'm doing shortcuts again, as you do, through this village. Just have a look. That way?
Yeah.
Just straight?
Yeah.
Thank you. Apparently there's a doctor just near that mountain. I want to go to him.
Or to the mine?
Yeah.
I'll just take this one.
So that way?
Yeah, just take this way.
Can I go through here?
You can.
Yeah.
You can.
So just go that way.
Yeah, you find the big road there. Just take the big one.
All right, cool.
Up the big market, then take corner down this side.
Thank you. Hello. Private clinic. Which way? Doctor.
Good.
Private clinic. Doctor? That way? Doctor!
Doctor!
That way? I think it's that way anyway. Thank you. I'll go. Thank you. Clinic, a doctor. Apparently he's somewhere there, is that right? Okay, so I have to turn around to the main road and go that way. Okay, thank you. I've just arrived at this clinic at Cape Montclair to get my tablets for Bilharzia and to ask local doctor a few questions, because I think it's so important to actually send a message out. There's too so many people traveling through Malawi without knowing that you can get parasite from the Malawi lake. So this is the sort of risky and decision you need to make. You're either going to swim and treat yourself for Bilharzia, or just don't swim at all and don't shower at the local camping grounds, which is very, very hard to do because it's like so beautiful. I swam, that was my choice, and now I'm about to get tablets for the treatment. So we are now at Cape Montclair. This is Dr. Moses. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
For spending me this few minutes. And I just want to ask you, doctor, about
Bilharzia. Because I'm still, you know, I'm riding around Africa, and I've met a lot of people who are not aware that the virus, that parasite, is still in Malawi Lake. So tell me, what's the, if you choose to swim in Malawi Lake, what's the chance of getting the parasite?
Okay, the chances of getting the parasite are very high. Only that in some people, the symptoms, they don't show symptoms
at all.
So they may stay for quite a long period of time without showing anything, and that's very dangerous. And in some people, they show signs and symptoms.
Straight away.
Yeah.
What are the symptoms, if you have the symptoms?
The symptoms are, you feel pain when passing out urine, with terminal blood, as well as you can also have diarrhea, which is blood not responding to any antibiotics.
If you're taking those tablets, because it's just one day treatment, isn't it? According to your weight. Will cure it you 100%?
Yes, it's 100% the cure. You get cured 100%.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when should we be taking those tablets?
So it's better to take the treatment after 2 weeks.
Wow.
Or in some people they say I'll take it after 6 weeks or 4 weeks, but within a period of 2 weeks it's okay.
It's better.
But yeah, but staying
and
without
this
the treatment
will kill all types of them.
Yes.
Okay. And those tablets, apparently they're very nasty, they're not good for you, so if you don't have it, it's better not to take it. So do you think it's better to do the blood test to actually see if you have the virus and then take the treatment, or should you just take the treatment?
Here in Malawi, because of we don't have enough resources for that,
tests.
In most of the cases, we just take the treatment. But if you keep on showing the signs and symptoms, we do urine test.
Right.
Yeah, at times you can capture it, or even on the microscope.
Right.
Yeah.
Blood test. I know, you know, I've heard so many horrible stories what happened to people because they didn't have any symptoms for a year and a half, 2 years, and then they had bladder cancer and then all sorts of problems and complications.
Some of the complications that they take a longer period of time to show up, like the bladder cancer, urinary tract system cancer, which in most of the cases it attacks the bladder, urinary bladder, because of continued irritation to the bladder. So you develop that. Yeah, in some cases we have unexplained anemia. We might call it unexplained anemia because if you didn't take the drug, it becomes very difficult for you to say maybe it's Bilharzia if you don't put it in mind that I once visited an area that is infested.
And it's just Malawi Lake, or pretty much it can be in all African lakes, the parasite?
Not in all African lakes, but most of the lakes in Africa, most of them. We have that problem.
And what about the locals? How do they get the treatment? Because, you know, they swim, they pretty much, you know, they fish, they wash their clothes, they living at the lake all the time. What treatment do they get? Do they just regular treatment?
Here?
Yeah.
Yeah. At least every six months.
They get that?
Yeah, they get treatment. Yeah, and we combine it with abendazole, which is for the intestinal worms. So if you have that types of worm, it means that if you take treatment for Bilharzia, because that treatment kills also some of the worms, intestinal worms. So if you happen to take treatment for Bilharzia and those worms are not eradicated, it means the Bilharzia will be
still there.
Will be still there. But if you take abendazole, which for the worms, it means
everything is gone.
Yeah. bike, yeah? Here? This way? Oh, that way. Thank you. Which way? That way? Through here? No, too much. Not enough. That way? That's a bit tight. No, eh? No. Oh. Hold on. This is a nice road, I really like it. Oh, by the way, I'm in Malawi at the moment.